office and place, your restoration is guaranteed. You shall be restored. When you are armed with obedience to the word of God, the storms of life must bow down. Every storm that comes your way shall become stepping stones to higher grants.
In the name of Jesus.
If that clap is for Jesus, make it bigger, make it louder. He's a good God. He's faithful. He has done you well. Praise God. I said, praise God. Tonight, it's my privilege to be able to stand here to share the word of God with us briefly before we partake of the Lord's table. And I believe, God, that tonight, the portion that God has in stock for each one shall be delivered in Jesus' name. Amen. Let that amen be a louder one. Amen. Remember that all this week, we've been looking at the subject, prayer and fasting is the altar of empowerment. Can you say that with me, please, everyone? Praise God. And we are going to be taking two quick scriptures tonight as our text before we go into the word. Please open with me to Luke chapter 10 and verse 19. Luke chapter 10 and verse 19. Prayer and fasting is the altar of empowerment. Luke chapter 10, verse 19. Shall we read together, please? One, two, go. Behold, I give unto you power to tread on serpents and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt you. If that's yours and you receive it, say it loud and clear, I receive it. Second scripture is taken from 1 Corinthians chapter 4 and verse 20. 1 Corinthians chapter 4 and verse 20. 1, 2, go. For the kingdom of God is not in power, but in word. May the Lord bless the reading of his word in our hearts in Jesus' name. Not in word, but in power. Prayer and fasting is the altar of empowerment. Remember, the 21 days prayer and fasting for the year 2015 is on the 11th day, and the 11th day is almost over, which means we have gone more than 50%. Thank God you made it. Give the Lord a big clap if you're excited about that. Say, thank God I made it. God who has helped you this far, he will help you to the end. You will not faint in the middle of the journey. Amen. More than 50% time have come and gone. This time next week, by the grace of God, we'll be close to the 21 days. The examination started 11 days ago. And now, we are more than halfway. You must come out of this examination hall smiling. Whatever might have been creating tension in your life, in your career, in your relationships, in your finances, in any area of your life, in this examination hall, this year 2015, you must overcome it. Amen. And I hear believing amen. Amen. You know, if you have 2 hours, 10 minutes to write a particular exam, and then 1 hour is gone, and you haven't even answered 3 questions, you already know what results you are going to take home. But you are not permitted to fail. And so, like we have been told from the beginning, don't just be a participant. Make sure you are a partaker. And tonight, again, as you partake of the Lord's table, the grace, the strength, the vigor, and all that is required for you and I to be partakers shall be released unto us in Jesus' name. As we begin tonight, let's establish the fact that, one, Jesus already paid the ultimate price for your empowerment. Remember, we're talking about prayer and fasting. It's the altar of empowerment. Jesus already paid the ultimate price for your empowerment. Say loud amen to that.
Amen.
Colossians chapter 2 and verse 15. Look at what the Bible says here. Having spoiled principalities and what? And what? And powers, Jesus made a show of them openly, triumphing over them in it because of you. He made a show of principalities and powers, triumphing over them because of you and me. He already, therefore, paid the ultimate price. You and I shall not disappoint destiny.
Amen.
After he paid the price, what did he do? Luke's Gospel, chapter 10 and verse 19. We just read it a while ago. Luke 10, 19. I give unto you what? Power. He made the show of them in Colossians 2, 15. And then in Luke chapter 10, verse 19, he says, I now give that power to who? Say with me,
I receive it.
Louder yet, I receive it. The loudest you can, I receive it. I give it unto you. So he already paid the ultimate price for your empowerment. And that's why these 21 days must not end without you and my own power status changing. Thank God for the level of empowerment that you and I have right now. But your level must change for the better. Say with me, I'm changing level. Louder yet, I'm changing level. Would you please convince your neighbor, you must change level. Shout a loud amen. Number two, very importantly, we must also establish the fact that prayer and fasting is the believer's spiritual power station. He already paid the price, yes. He gave it to you, yes. But have you received it? We cannot lay hold on it without prayer and fasting. So prayer and fasting is the believer's power, spiritual power station. It is the believer's power station. Prayer and fasting is the believer's power station. And it's been said very clearly, and we must get to understand this, that what breathing is to life is what prayer and fasting is to the believer. What breathing is to life is what prayer and fasting is to the believer. It's a necessity. It's not optional. Is breathing optional? It's not. It's compulsory. We are told that a certain number of days you can live without food. Lesser number of days you can live without water, but without breathing, you cannot live for one day. Now take that and translate it to prayer and fasting. What breathing is to life is what prayer and fasting is to the believer. It's a necessity, it's not optional. And that's why when you read in scriptures, you see Jesus, he kept saying, when ye pray, when ye fast, when ye pray, when ye fast. So what we are going through right now, these 21 days, is a necessity. And as you partake of this, your power level will change positively.
Amen.
Let me hear you say, I receive it.
I receive it.
Say it again, I receive it.
I receive it.
Louder yet, I receive it.
I receive it.
As you have declared it, so shall it be for you. In actual fact, prayer and fasting can become your spiritual atomic bomb with which you devastate the kingdom of darkness and release yourself into a higher level of dominion. Spiritual atomic bomb. With it, you devastate the kingdom of darkness and all of its cohorts arrayed in your direction. Against your life, your career, your family, your future, your destiny. And then you exert and exercise dominion here on earth. Somebody is changing level. Amen. If you are that person, let me hear you shout a loud amen. Amen. We must understand, therefore, that we must build up in the realm of power to subdue the enemy. We have to build up. We must build up in the realm of power to subdue the what? The enemy. To build up is a personal, non-transferable responsibility. No one else can build up for another. The pastor cannot build up for a member. Wife cannot build up for husband. Husband cannot build up for wife. Parents cannot build up for children. It's a personal responsibility. And as you build up these 21 days, I see you taking dominion, taking authority, moving forward, and devastating the kingdom of darkness, and establishing the will and the plan and the purpose of God Almighty in your life. Can I hear a believing amen? Amen. We must build up. It's time to build up. Tell your neighbor, please, on my behalf, it's time to build up. Tell someone on the other side the same thing. It's time to build up. Tell yourself now, it's time to build up. Shout aloud, I'm believing, amen. Amen. To build up in the realm of power to subdue the enemy. Who is actually your enemy and my enemy? We must understand this. In his book, Born to Win, God's servant clearly narrated this. And I hope some of us will get back and read that book again. Most of us have it. Or listen to the audio. Your real enemy, my real enemy, is the devil. 1 Peter chapter 5 and verse 8 makes it very clear. He has agents, yes. But the Bible says, be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the who? Who is your adversary? Louder, everyone. Louder as you can. The devil. He goes about like a roaring lion, seeking who he may devour. He will not succeed in your direction. If he has been able to make any point in your life and against your destiny in time past, that will be the last he will ever be able to make. Any further attempt from his direction in your own direction shall be met with devastation. And all of his agents will also be met with devastation. So your adversary, my adversary, is the devil. It is the devil. But in Mark's Gospel chapter 3 and verse 27, Mark chapter 3 and verse 27, the Bible makes it very clear. No man can enter into a strong man's house and spoil his goods except he will first bind the strong man and do what? Spoil his house. Bind the strong man. Bind the strong. How do you bind the strong man, the devil? One primary way you do that is through the instrumentality of prayer and what? And fasting. You bind the devil and then you lay hold on your goods. You know what? No matter what your past might be like, the good news today is that whatever the devil stole from you in time past, he must return it sevenfold. Not next year, but this year. Not just this year, but this month. Not just this month, but before the end of these 21 days. Whatever the enemy succeeded in stealing from you, the Bible says if the thief is caught, he will pay sevenfold. Get ready for complete restoration. God is too faithful to fail. Whatever he has declared, he stands by his word to perform it. This year is your year of heaven and earth, where restoration is the order of the day. You shall no longer be denied. Build up power to subdue the enemy. The word subdue, among other things, means to have dominion, to exercise authority, to take control. From this day forward, I see you beginning to take control in every area of your life in Jesus' name. Remember, it's only those who are endued with power that can subdue the devil. Until you are endued with power from on high, you cannot successfully subdue the devil. It's only those who are endued with power that can subdue the devil, to dominate the devil. And this endowment we are talking about is not just once in a lifetime. It has to be done consistently. And it has to be done continuously. And what a joy tonight we are here again on the sound of the word of God and to partake of the Lord's table. I guarantee you, a fresh endowment will become your portion in Jesus' name. Job chapter 22 and verse 28. The Bible says, you shall decree a thing. And what will happen? You shall decree a thing. It shall be established unto you. And the light will shine upon your ways. Whatever you decree from this day forward, heaven will sanction it for you. Amen. Can I hear a believing amen? Amen. What therefore is the purpose of prayer and fasting? What's the purpose of prayer and fasting? One, for salvation of souls. That is the primary purpose of prayer and fasting. Some of us even have some of our family members that are not saved yet. They are not born again yet. They don't know Christ yet. They are thorns in your flesh and you know it. They are clogs in the wheel of your destiny. They are slowing down the pace of things in your life. For how long will this continue? Say with me, no more. Say like you believe it, no more. Salvation of souls is one major reason, one primary purpose. Matthew's Gospel chapter 9 and verse 36. Matthew chapter 9 and verse 36. When Jesus saw the multitudes, he was moved with what? He was moved with compassion. When you are truly empowered, you will have compassion for the lost. When you are truly empowered, you will have compassion for the lost. It was a great man of God, Charles G. Spurgeon, a man that said, if you don't have passion for the lost, and I'm paraphrasing this right now, then you yourself, you are not saved. If you have no passion for the lost, the guarantee is you yourself, you're already lost. Your destiny shall not be lost. And so as we go through this 21 days prayer and fasting, I want you to believe God to equip you afresh with passion for souls. Passion for souls. And as you do that, you see that your level of command will keep changing positively in Jesus' name. Can I hear a believing amen? John chapter 6 and verse 44. John 6, 44. John chapter 6 and verse 44. No man can come to me, Jesus says, except the Father, which has sent me, draw him. So when you are truly empowered, you pray to the Father to draw men to his kingdom. That's why you see us in this commission every time we gather. Prayer points for the lost. Prayer points for souls. Prayer points for multiplication. Why? That is the essence of true empowerment. May that grace come upon you too afresh. Amen. Luke chapter 1, verses 21 and 22. We talked about the strong man. And there is no way. So Luke chapter 11, verses 21 and 22. There is no way you can take the goods of the strong man until you are able to bind him. Satan has bound so many people down. It takes empowered saints to decree their liberty. It takes empowered saints to decree their liberty. And watch it. As you begin to decree their liberty, salvation of souls, men and women, will begin to rush into the kingdom of God. Stand in the gap this time. Even for those your wonderful family members who are not in the kingdom of God yet, let compassion grip you and see what God will do in your life. Because as they get saved, there's joy in heaven, and you are also enjoying joy here on earth. And when that happens, everything contrary to joy, joblessness, sorrow, fear, oppression, you see them on their own accord, willingly disappearing. Somebody's story is changing for the better. Yeah. Acts chapter 1 and verse 8, you shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost has come upon you. Then you shall be witnesses unto me. So the primary reason God empowers us, the believer, is to be witnesses unto him. Witnesses unto him. During the prayer session tonight, we prayed also that God will make you and I living witnesses. 10 men holding to your skirt and say, I will follow you to serve your God. That's God turning you and I to living witnesses. That will be somebody's story this year. And that's me. How about you? As you have declared it, God will make it happen for you in the name of Jesus Christ. John chapter 3 and verse 16. God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten son. And whosoever believeth on him should not perish. Should not perish. Should not perish. It is not the will of God for any man to perish. In your family lineage, nobody will go to hell. Amen. Make that amen, a believing one. Amen. The same thing is repeated in 2 Peter chapter 3 and verse 9. God is not slow, but it's because he does not want any to perish. Grace to have greater compassion for souls. Receive it tonight in Jesus' name. And finally, number 2, for establishment of souls. The first one is for their salvation. The second is for their establishment. Remember, once saved is not always saved. So, it's important not just to pray them to be saved, but also to be established. Jesus speaking said very clearly, there are many who are last, they be first. Many who are first, they be last. That will not be your story. Yeah. I said that will not be your story. Yeah. So it's important to also pray for them to be established. Colossians chapter 4 and verse 12. Colossians chapter 4 and verse 12. Epaphras, who is one of you, a servant of Christ, saluted you, always laboring fervently for you in what? That you may stand perfect and complete in all the will of God. Grace to labor fervently for the establishment of souls. Not that you will walk and evangelize and 50 people probably will follow you to church and then at the end of 6 months, all of them have disappeared into the thin air. You shall no longer labor in vain. Yeah. Can I hear a believing amen? Yeah. And then Galatians chapter 4 and verse 29. Galatians chapter 4 and verse 29. But as then he that was born after the flesh persecuted him that was born after the spirit, so it is now. The enemy keeps on looking for opportunity to keep persecuting and to see how he can draw back. But in your case, he will not succeed. I'm sure you also know people who were born again, probably at the same time with you, but now they are no longer in the kingdom of God. Do I have a witness in the house? Some of them are so backslidden that there's no trace in their lives that they were ever born again. That will not be your story. For the establishment of souls. And upon this table tonight, that grace is made available. To be empowered to pray for the salvation of souls and for the establishment of those souls. Therefore, it is wisdom to make it a project. Before the end of these 21 days, it is wisdom to make it a project. So that your labor shall not be wasted. Make it a project, number 1. And then 2, expect that as you make it a project, it will produce in your life. Tonight, a change of story awaits somebody here. As you partake of the Lord's table and as you spend time on your own in prayer for empowerment over and again, remember the power of a one-line prayer. Empowerment. Empowerment for salvation of souls and for their establishment. You yourself will discover that your level of command will keep changing for the better in Jesus' name. Welcome, therefore, to your season of greater empowerment in Jesus' name. Say, I receive it if you do. Please rise up on your feet with me right now as we pray. And just in one moment, just pray that one line prayer for yourself. Lord, empower me again tonight afresh for soul winning and establishment of souls. Lift up your voice. Pray that prayer for yourself in one moment. Lord, empower me afresh again tonight for soul winning and for establishment of souls. Empower me again. Lord, I want to change level. Remember, no one else can pray for you like you. So lift up your voice right now to the Lord Almighty and pray. Lord, empower me. Empower me afresh tonight for soul winning and for salvation of souls. Lord, change my level of command. Change my level of authority. Change my level of command. Change my level of authority. I don't want to labor in vain anymore. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Shout, shout it loud, hallelujah. Just one moment, you pray one prayer for yourself. In this journey of these 21 days, you will not be weary. You will not be tired. You will not faint. You will finish and come out of this examination hall smiling. Exerting and exercising dominion in the name of Jesus Christ. Lift up your voice to the Lord in 1 minute and pray that prayer for yourself. Pray in your understanding and pray in the spirit. Your level of command must change for the better. It must change. Before these 21 days are over, my level of command must change. Speak to the Lord. Pray for yourself. Pray in the spirit. Pray in your understanding. Oh God, I stand today and I receive grace. I shall not faint. I shall not be weary. Lord, I shall not faint. I shall not be weary. My level of command must change before the end of these 21 days. Lord, I look up to you for fresh empowerment. Ebo barakataya lakro babodiga sokataraba lego garaba balako satala e yakota poriga dalaba. Father, I give you praise and glory. Thank you and thank you. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Please lift up your right hand to the Lord. As you have prayed and heaven has heard you, so God will establish it in your life. You shall not be weary. You shall not faint. Amen. You will run this race successfully to the end. Amen. Your strength shall be renewed. Amen. Your level of command will change. Amen. God's name shall be glorified. Amen. Whatever you stood in gap for today, especially during this session for personal supplication, we decree it established. Amen. And that speedily. Amen. Thank you, Father. Because we know it is done. And we give you all the glory. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
We believe that you have been blessed by today's teaching. To get more materials and resources online, visit our website at www.davidoyedepoministries.org.